Hello everybody, if you'd like to be informed when I post new videos, you have to click the subscribe button right there down below, and that will keep you informed automatically. Okay, this is Texas for the last 4 years. Real drought. This is Texas now that we've had some rain before, after.
Texas is under threat again this morning from a relentless and deadly cycle of rain and flooding. More heavy rain and lightning lashed areas around Dallas overnight. Some parts of the state have seen more than a foot of rain in recent days.
After days of deadly flooding, President Obama has signed a federal disaster declaration for Texas. Just this week, severe weather has killed at least 22 people in Texas. This has been the wettest May on record for Texas. The state has gotten nearly 17 inches of rain. CNN's Dan Simon reports that residents may be in for even more this weekend.
A highway turned into a parking lot near Dallas. The rain's coming down so fast, the freeway turning into a lake. And a desperate rescue mission for a police officer stuck in the same downpour. A helicopter pulls him to safety. But check out these homes in Liberty, Texas, surrounded entirely by water. And folks in the rural community forced to herd animals through the marsh using an airboat. And just as some communities clean up the mess that left hundreds of houses in ruins, authorities fear the worst may not be over.
I would like to say that it is, but I'm not sure that the worst is over because of the way that the weather is running, and we are so saturated in almost all parts of Texas.
And now this, a Fox News alert. You are looking live at a dam just south of Dallas that has now begun to breach.
What?
The pounding rain this weekend causing the water to start rushing right over the top. Take a look at this. Officials warning that this dam could break completely, and up to 20 feet of water could spill right into the area, causing flash floods.
Track that for you.
What must you be thinking if you're living by there in Dallas right now?
A 20-foot high wall of water as a result of that.
So scary. We're going to stay on that for you.
Here we have one of our very many flooded golf courses, but a true golfer is never held back by the extra problems that they have to deal with. It's just another hazard on the course, and that's just the way the game rolls. I wonder though if they have cleated boots to wear or for their golfing or what. Here's a Walmart that been flooded out. You can see the area here and rescue vehicles trying to traverse their way through the water. It's course, not very deep here, but it's flooding out a lot of things, causing a lot of damage. There's a car dealership out in front of the Walmart that's lost probably half their inventory to flooding there. And that's supposed to be an intersection. There we got the parking lot, and you see a lot of RVers and a few cars. They're trying to get off the roads and avoid the floods, and that didn't work out too well because they wound up in the flood anyway. Here's the back of the Walmart, and you can see it's just surrounded by water on all sides. It's really a big shame. There's the river that was going through there, and you can see how it's flooded right up over the banks there. It's a real bad shame. A poor rancher here that lost his house. Okay, this is footage that I shot at our campground when we were out there for spring break. You may recognize it. Only the evergreens are green. The regular trees are just brown. There's no leaves on them, and we hadn't had much rain, and the lake level there is pretty much normal. Now, we've gone forward in time about a month, 5 weeks. This is Memorial Day weekend, and you see we have a little flooding problem. And no, that is not a boat ramp. I'm sorry, I don't have a shirt on. I was going to go swimming until I looked at the clarity of the water. It was disgusting. Anyway, this is not a boat ramp. Neither is this. And it was, that was a entrance, and the other there is an exit to a parking lot that's now completely underwater. A parking lot for a picnic area. And now you can see that the lake is quite a bit bigger. This is shot in about the same spot, real close. And we had gotten so much rain. It just rained and rained and rained. And the ground couldn't take anymore. Started backing up. See all that water in amongst the trees there? That's all a picnic area on dry land, or it's supposed to be. Water there in the middle is some 25, 30 feet deep. And the other picture I just showed you, it was dry land. See how it goes into the trees there and everything. And there we are down there, straight down. And that's the entrance to the parking lot. The lake normally is, for the last 4 or 5 years, has been running about 9 feet below normal because we have not had much rain. Now, all of a sudden, we're about 20 feet above normal. It's just incredible. It's just ridiculous. And the lakes can't handle it. In fact, they tried to open the floodgates and they couldn't get them open. They hadn't been opened in 5 years and they were stuck. So there's the golf cart and me standing next to it. And all that's supposed to be dry land, even at the very top of your screen, all that water is not supposed to be there. And this was like on Thursday or Friday before Memorial Day weekend. On Monday, Tuesday, Memorial Day and the day after, this water here was even deeper. Right there, was about a foot when I shot this, and the day after Memorial Day, it was about 3 feet. And that area where the golf carts parked was completely underwater by a foot and a half or so. So, see that white thing going across the very top of the screen right there? It's on the other shore. I'll show you that again in a minute. All that's right there is normally dry. It's always dry, all of that. So this is what it looks like now. And you might notice that there's no brown trees. All the trees are green. And they grew, even the ones with leaves. You know, there's one or two oddballs there that have died off, I guess. But basically they're all. And you thought I was just kidding about the before and after. Now let me try and line up these two shots here. See if I can't get us a before and after picture for a moment. There we go. The one on the left's a little blurry, but it's before. These are about 4.5 to 5 weeks apart. And I mentioned earlier that white thing at the top of the screen. You can see then the left, and then on the right it's floating. On the left it's kind of not. That's a fishing dock that's next to the boat ramp for people to fish off of the dock. And it doesn't move. That's how much the water's changed. So let's look at the next item up for business here.
San Antonio, how you get
through
that?
Oh, it's going to be a year or two.
Oh my God.
You pray for rain?
Be careful what you pray.
See how high the debris was in the trees?
Okay, see that wadded up ball of tree roots and stuff right there? That's how high the water got here. Look at that. That was huge. It knocked that road right off the bridge and threw it down 20 feet downstream. Look at all those beautiful trees that used to be on the shore. All wiped out. They're all gonna die. Look at the damage to the homes back off of the stream so far, and yet damage so bad. It's just incredible. Our heart really goes out to these people. It's so sad. Our prayers are with them. They've endured something terrible. Look at that. It's like a tornado. It's just such a shame. I've made light a few times in this video, but this is a serious thing. When that water goes, it goes.
Look at this, this is the count.
Just broke it off and then that tree broke it like a twig.
So the next time that you're thinking about driving across that stream of raging water or playing on the shore as the water rages by, you think about this video. That search and rescue helicopter, they could be looking for you.
And the Texas flag still standing.